Hello, this is the lecture number 4 for the chapter Complex Number, class 11th, and we are starting with the miscellaneous exercise. In the question number 1, you have to find the whole cube of this I raised to power 18 upon 1 upon raised to power 25. First of all, you simplify I raised to power 18 and I raised to power 25. For I raised to power 18, you can write I raised to power 4 raised to power 4 into I square. And for this 1 upon I raised to power 25, you can write I raised to power minus 25. So, or rather you can rationalize 1 upon I. If you rationalize 1 upon I, you will get minus I. So, you can write minus I raised to power 25 also. So, any power with the minus I raised to power 25 will give you minus I raised to power 25. Now this I raised to power 4 will be equal to 1, 1 raised to power 4, and I square is equal to minus 1. So I raised to power 25, and this comes out to be minus 1, and again break this I raised to power 25, which will be equal to I raised to power 4 into power 6 into I. So 1 raised to power 6 into I, so this comes out to be minus 1 minus I raised to power 3. You take minus 1 common here, and the cube of minus will be this minus here, and find the whole cube of this. 1 plus I raised to power whole cube, a cube plus b cube plus 3a square into b plus 3ab square. On simplification, you are getting 2 minus 2i, which is in the form a plus ib. You simplify this very carefully. 1 upon I raised to power 25, 1 upon I will be equal to, on rationalizing, I upon I square will be equal to minus I. This will be the value of this 1 upon I. Now you have to prove that in question number 2, the real part of Z1 into Z2 is equal to real part of Z1, real part of Z2 minus imaginary part of Z1 into imaginary part of Z2. So for this, you let any complex number Z1 is equal to A plus IB. The second complex number will be equal to C plus ID. Z1 into Z2 means you have to multiply these two complex numbers. On multiplication, A into C, A into DI, B into CI, BDI square. You are getting anything? I square is equal to minus 1. So these are two real parts and these are two imaginary parts. So separate them, real part and imaginary part. Now you have to find the real part of Z1 into Z2, which is equal to A minus C, A into C minus BD. Now what is A here? A is the real part of Z1, C is the real part of Z2, B is imaginary part of Z1, I have written it here, and D is the imaginary part of Z2. Now I have added one more part in this. Imaginary part of Z1 into Z2 will be equal to AD plus BC. So I have written it here, AD plus BD, BC, where A is the real part of Z1. D is the imaginary part of Z2, B is the imaginary part of Z1, and C is the real part of Z2. So I've added second part in this question also. Now in question number 3, you have to simply write this expression in A plus IB form. Some calculation part of is there, so you can use your own calculation part. I've done like this. So first of all, I've subtracted those by taking the LCM and arranging them in A plus IB form. So on simplification, I've got this. Multiplying the denominator, I'm getting this. Now multiply these two brackets in the numerator as well as in the denominator, I'm getting this. On simplification, I'm getting this. 33 plus 3i upon 28 minus 8i. And after that, rationalize by changing the sign of the imaginary part. So on multiplication, some large calculation is there. You have to write this in the form A plus IB. A plus IB. You can like do like this also. You first of all rationalize this denominator, rationalize this denominator, rationalize this denominator, and then you can multiply. First of all, subtract and then multiply. Some big calculation is there, but always write the complex number in the standard form. Now, in question number 4, it is an important question. It is given that x minus iy is equal to this, and you have to prove that x square plus y square is equal to under root a square plus b square upon under root c square plus d square. Now, x minus iy is equal to under root a minus ib c minus id. You are squaring both the sides. We are getting this. Now, taking modulus on both sides, dono side, you take the modulus because we need under root a square plus b square, which is the modulus of under root, modulus of a minus ib. So, squaring both the sides, taking modulus on both sides. Now, see this, in place of this, I've written this because z square modulus is equal to modulus of z square. So, in place of this, I've written this. Aage. Modulus of this whole square. See this. And whole modulus is break into z1 into z2 because we know that modulus of z1 upon z2 is equal to z1 modulus upon z2 modulus. So this is the main step in this. This is the main step in this. Now modulus of x minus I y is equal to under root a square plus b square. Modulus of a minus I b is equal to under root a square plus b square. And modulus of c minus id is equal to modulus under root c square plus d square. You are getting this. So if you square this, square root will cancel out. So x square plus y square is equal to under root a square plus b square. You are squaring both the sides again, the square root of this will be cancelled out. So I am repeating it again. This is given and you have to prove that this x square y square whole square is equal to a square plus b square c square. ये आपको प्रूव करना है. तो व्हाट आई हैव डन, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल रिमूव द स्क्वायर रूट बाय स्क्वायरिंग बोथ द साइड. आई हैव टेकन द मॉडुलस ऑन बोथ साइड. देन आई यूज दिस प्रॉपर्टी दैट मॉडुलस z स्क्वायर मॉडुलस इज इक्वल टू मॉडुलस स्क्वायर. हियर आई हैव यूज दिस. एंड z1 अपॉन z2 होल मॉडुलस इज इक्वल टू z1 मॉडुलस अपॉन z2 मॉडुलस. वी हैव डन दिस. And we know that the modulus under root x square plus y square and a square plus b square under root c square plus d square. Squaring both the sides, we are getting this. Now you have to write this in the standard form. First of all, find the whole square of the denominator under root a square plus b square minus 2ab. You are getting this. Rationalize it by changing the sign of the imaginary part or multiply numerator denominator by the conjugate of the denominator. And after this, you are getting minus 1 plus I, which is in the standard form. A plus IB ki form mein aapko likhna hai. Now, after that, you have to convert this into the polar form. Actually, you have to convert this into the polar form. First of all, to convert into the polar form, first of all, you have to write in the A plus IB form. After rationalizing it, we are getting this in the standard form. Now, you have to convert this into the polar form, which you have done in the previous exercise also. So let this is equal to in the polar form r cos theta plus I sin theta. So real part is r cos theta is equal to minus 1. Imaginary part is r sin theta, which is equal to 1. Squaring and adding, you'll get the value of r. Squaring and adding, you are doing these questions in the second exercise. And to find the argument, we divide these two equations. So r sin theta upon r cos theta is equal to 1 upon minus 1. Now here sine is positive and cos is negative, so theta will be in the second quadrant. So tan theta is equal to minus 1 means, because sine theta is positive and cos theta is negative, so the theta will lie in the second quadrant. So for 1 you can write minus pi by 4 to convert into second quadrant. For minus pi by 4 we write 180 minus pi by 4, which is equal to 3 pi by 4. So this is the argument for this principal argument for this complex number minus 1 plus I. So the polar form will be r cos theta plus I sine theta. So this is the polar form of this complex number, where we have converted this into, first of all, into the A plus IB form, and then we have converted this into this polar form by letting it equal to r cos theta plus I sine theta. So this is the question number 5 of the miscellaneous exercise. Let us take the question number, another question. Let us take question number 10 after this, because question number 6, 7, 8, 9, they are the simple, the solution of the quadratic equation whose discriminant is negative. Now in question number 10, you have to find the modulus of this z1 plus z2 plus 1 upon z1 minus z2 plus 1. Now as usual, we have the whole modulus. We can break into, separate the modulus, because we know that z1 upon z2 whole modulus is equal to z1 modulus upon z2 modulus, as we have done in the last question also. The value of z1, z2, z1, z2 is given. Simplify the numerator, we are getting 4. Simplify the denominator, we are getting 2 minus 2i. The modulus of 4 will be 4, and the modulus of 2 minus 2i will be under root a square plus b square, which is equal to root 8. On simplification, we are getting root 2 is the value of this modulus. So this is the up to question number 10. We'll discuss the remaining question in the next lecture. Thank you.